Konnichiwa, it's Heidi. We are going to talk about sushi and how do you eat sushi with chopsticks? Or do you? Oh, you better stay tuned to find out. Konnichiwa. Well, hello and welcome. It's Heidi Doulaban, International Cultural Consultant and Etiquette Expert. Super happy you're with me today. We are going to talk about sushi. How do you eat sushi with chopsticks? Or do you? Well, stay tuned. You better stay tuned. So we're talking about sushi. Let's just take a little trip to Japan, if you will, or your nearest and favorite sushi bar. And we're going to just talk about all things sushi. So let's start at the beginning. Where did sushi come from? Well, sushi has its roots in fish preservation. Yes, we're talking millennia ago. Fish was packed in vinegar and rice as a means to preserve it, and it was fermented. And that method of preservation had its roots in China that had come to Japan by way of the Korean Peninsula. So a lot of history there, and then it was evolving and changed throughout the centuries, and then we're all the way up to the Edo period, which in Japan was around the early 1600s to about the mid 1800s or so. And that's when Japan was closed off. All these beautiful national cultural things happened, just flourished in Japan, and modern day sushi was one of them. And of course it kept evolving a little bit, but now today here we are and we have this beautiful sushi to enjoy. Okay, so what is the etiquette when we're going to go to our favorite sushi bar? Well, there is some etiquette, and I want you to know, because in Japan, it is all about respect. And we need to respect this beautiful sushi and think about all that went into it. Because to be a sushi chef, it can take decades. It can take a lifetime, an absolute lifetime. Did you know that there is a fantastic sushi chef named Jiro in Tokyo? He's in his late 90s now, and there's a great old movie if you want to look it up, Jiro Dreams of Sushi. It's magnificent. He lives in Tokyo, and he is in his late 90s now, and I read recently that he said he is still perfecting his sushi making skills, and he's been doing it since he was a teenager. So that gives you an idea of the skill that is involved in making beautiful, perfect sushi. Just the person making the rice, that can take a decade or more to learn just how to perfectly make the rice. So it's so interesting. And just by the way, did you know that Tokyo, while we're talking about Tokyo, has more Michelin stars than Paris? That's true. Tokyo has 212 Michelin-starred restaurants as of 2021, compared to Paris's 113. Way to go, Tokyo. But, you know, I will say this, though, that France, by far as a country, has many more Michelin-starred restaurants than any other country. But the second is Japan, so there you go. Okay, so now we are going to just say, let's just set a scenario that we are going to go to a beautiful sushi bar for dinner. Let's just break it down and go through the etiquette. So first things first, cool it on the cologne and perfume, because part of this whole beautiful experience is the smells. And did you know that 80% of our taste comes from our smell? So cool it on the perfume, watch big chunky jewelry. You don't want to damage a beautiful sushi bar, not the time for that. And so when you arrive at the sushi bar and you're seated, you should say, "Thank you, I'm excited about enjoying this meal." So you thank them. And then you sit down, and then we're just going to break a few things down. How about chopsticks? Yes, we are going to be using our chopsticks, and I have some here. I hope that you can see them. I'll move my soy sauce. I have some beautiful Japanese chopsticks here. I've actually had these since I was 9 years old. As a gift to me, my dad took me to Japan. So I'm not sure if you know how to properly hold your chopsticks or not, but I'll give you a quick refresher. Okay, so the bottom chopstick is the static one. It does not move. It sits here in the crease of your thumb. Your thumb holds it down, and then your ring finger and pinky hold it static. It does not move. The top chopstick does all the work, and so it is placed at the top of your thumb. I hope you can see this, and it is held with your index finger with pointer and your middle finger, and it does all the work. It's the only one that moves. So there you go, little refresher. I know, you already knew that. I know. Okay, so in Japan, chopsticks are different around the world. They're different in the different countries when you are traveling in the Far East. So please be aware of that. In Japan, my chopsticks are very traditional. They're lacquered, and in Japan, generally speaking, the chopsticks are tapered. They go to a pointy end. And that makes sense because a big part of the Japanese diet is fish. And the pointy ends help us pick up the fish, and if there's a bone, help us get rid of any bones. Okay, so just a couple of things about chopsticks etiquette. We don't point them towards someone. In Japan, I have my chopsticks rest here, and it is holding my chopsticks, and the point is facing away, to pointing to the left of me. And we do not lick our chopsticks. We do not do, just like you do not lick a knife, you don't lick chopsticks, you don't gesture with them, you don't point with them, just like you don't point with a fork or a knife while you're speaking. So just a few things. Now you say, but Heidi, I don't have beautiful lacquered Japanese chopsticks. When I go, I'm given disposable chopsticks at my favorite sushi bar. So I have some here, but there's etiquette for this. So let me just tell you what the etiquette is for this. You would tear off one piece, the corner, and then you would slide out the chopsticks, right? Let me get these to slide these out. And there is, so you want to save the wrapper. We're saving the wrapper. And then they're stuck at the top, and then we just break them in two. And so then we hold them exactly the same. Top one is the worker, does all the work. Okay, so we'd use them exactly the same way. Please never ever rub your chopsticks together. That's very rude. I see that all the time. People take them out of the wrapper and start rubbing them together. It's rude. It's an insult, because that says this restaurant is so low, it's so cheap, and they've given me such cheap chopsticks that I must rub them together to get any splinters off. And so that's an insult. So please do not do that. And then at the end of the meal, just let me tell you, there is etiquette for this. You take your wrapper and you slide your chopsticks back in, and you leave them at your place setting. So that is the proper etiquette with disposable chopsticks. Okay, so I'll put those aside, because now we're going to talk about our sushi. And we've already thanked the sushi chef for preparing this. And you just think about the work. Think about the years of experience that have gone into this. And so you're very appreciative. And let me just tell you the first thing, rookie mistake. You see it a lot. People will go in for the wasabi, and they'll immediately put wasabi into their soy sauce and make a little paste. Well, that is absolutely impolite, and here's why. They are very different flavors. They should not be mixed up like that. And in all the rolls, there is wasabi already in the rolls, so you would not add wasabi, unless you're crazy about it, to a roll. So then we also have ginger. Ginger is a palate cleanser. We would have a piece of ginger in between bites. That's to cleanse the palate so we can get ready for the next bite. You do not put ginger onto the top of any of your sushi, it's a palate cleanser. So just so you know that, because when you go to your sushi bar next time, you're going to be the hit. You are just going to be the hit. You're going to know everything. You're going to be just perfect on this. Okay, so now let's just talk about our sushi. Okay, so we have the maki, which are the sushi rolls, and they vary. There can be all kinds of different things in it, but remember what's in, we know is in there, is a bit of wasabi. Okay, then we have nigiri. Nigiri is the sushi with fish on the top and rice on the bottom. And then we have the beautiful sashimi. The sashimi is the raw fish that is so exquisitely carved, shaved, cut by the sushi chefs. And when you watch them do that and you think, oh my gosh, that knife must be as sharp as all get out. It is just this artistry watching them carve the sashimi. Okay, so now we're going to talk about how do we actually eat this, because we've got a little origin story, we've gone through all this, we know how to use our chopsticks, so now what? Okay, well, there's more etiquette to come. Here you go. With the rolls, sushi, the maki rolls, it is perfectly acceptable to pick them up with your finger. You can pick this up with your finger and eat them. Here is another tip. Sushi is designed, it is made for you. Each piece is one bite. Please don't pick up a piece of sushi and try to make two bites out of it. No, that's not done. It's one bite. Okay, oh, you knew that. Okay, so, but I said you can pick the roll up with your hands. You can also pick it up with your chopsticks. That's also fine. Now you say, but Heidi, I think I would like a little bit of soy sauce. Okay, there's soy sauce etiquette. It is considered impolite to waste, to cause waste in Japan. Again, it's all about respect. So when you pour some soy sauce into your container, your little soy sauce bowl, just a little bit. Just a little bit. Don't be wasteful. Okay, but here's the etiquette. When you pick up your roll, if you want to, the soy sauce is just as, it's not there to be a dunk bowl. You don't pop something in there and swash it around. No, it's just a little taste. You would just take your sushi and you would just take it in and just a little taste. And you never start sort of bouncing it and trying to get off any drips, because you know that you don't take that much soy sauce. It is just a tiny little bit. And then you would eat this one bite. Remember, it's just one bite. Okay, so that is the maki, all right? So now let's just say, okay, we've had the maki, and now we're going to go to the nigiri. Oh, I think I need a little palate cleanser, and then you could pick up and get a piece of ginger and eat this piece of ginger. And I'm not going to eat this. I'm going to save you from watching me eat something. Okay, so we've done this, and now we're going to have a piece of nigiri. That, there is etiquette with that. So let me show you. And trust me, you're going to remember all this. It's really easy once you do it. So I hope that you can see this, because as you see, there is the piece of fish is on the top and the rice is on the bottom. Now there is no wasabi on here. So if I'd like, I could put a little piece of wasabi on the top. That would be just fine. So I can eat this with my fingers, the nigiri. It's totally acceptable to eat that with my fingers, just as the maki rolls. But I'm going to show you how you eat it with your chopsticks. Same thing with your fingers. You should do the same thing. So, because the rice does not go into the soy sauce, it can fall apart. That's not what it is designed for. The soy sauce is designed really for the fish. So this is what we do. We take our nigiri roll and we roll it over onto its side. And we do this because then we pick it up and then we would take it and we would dunk just the tip of the fish, just the fish, into the soy sauce, and then we would eat it, one bite. So again, the nigiri, you turn it onto its side, you pick it up, and you turn it over, dunk just the tip of the fish into the soy sauce Okay, you've got this right. Okay. Alrighty, so now we have the sashimi, that beautifully carved fish, right? Okay, now we're going to have that. Okay, so the sashimi, if we'd like, we could put a little wasabi on that. And if you like, you could just dip a little end into the soy sauce if you like. However, here's where it differs when it comes to fingers. No fingers ever with the sashimi. It is only with chopsticks. Okay, so I'm going to get my chopsticks. Fingers are not allowed. And I'm going to pick up my piece and I think, okay, well, I would like just a little dink in there and then I would eat that. So that is how we eat sushi. At the end, we put our chopsticks back onto our rest and we thank the sushi chef for an incredible, beautiful meal and thank them for their hard work. It is such an art form. So did you pick up any tips? What did you learn today? I hope you learned something. There's so much more I could tell you. If you'd like to take a deep dive into this, I'd love to. I'll tell you more stories if you like. So please drop me a comment if you'd be so kind. We can take a much deeper dive into this. I'm trying to be respectful of your time. So thank you. I would love it. If you like this video, would you please drop me a like this video? And I would be so grateful if you'd be so kind as to subscribe to my channel. We can take all kinds of journeys together and talk about the etiquette of just about everything. So thank you, everyone. Please be safe and enjoy your next sushi experience. And please drop me a comment. I'm dying to hear about it. How did this video change how you're going to behave, how you're going to act at your next visit to your favorite sushi bar? You probably already do all this anyway, but it could be maybe a nice refresher. So thank you so much. And as I always say, please be kind. Arigato.